Shalom, Chavrim. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live, October the 21st, 2017. This story here is kind of a little bit unusual. I've been watching what's been going on with the Kurdish people trying to declare their independence in northern Iraq there, and Kirkuk being one of the places there, all along the northern border or the northern area of the Iraqi country there, where there is a much greater Kurdish prominence in the country. And of course, the Kurds have had, since the Gulf War, they have actually had self-autonomy in the northern part of Iraq. But now suddenly they have tried to bring out and set up their own nation. They have conducted a referendum. The people overwhelmingly have supported their own so-called Kurdistan. And of course, if you look on Google Maps here, this whole region, the northern region here from Kirkuk up to Erbil, all of this region here is where they're trying to declare their own statehood. This is what they're trying to do there. Now, ironically enough, the U.S. is using the Kurdish fighters here to the east of the, actually from Al Raqqa. So this whole eastern side of Syria, the U.S. has been now engaged with the Kurdish fighters there, trying to gain control of this entire eastern part of the country here. And while that's going on, and the Kurds are seeing that the U.S. has actually been very helpful in trying to help the Kurds to gain control of this part of Syria so that they can eventually turn that into their own state, this has caused the Kurds living in the northern part of Iraq to try to claim autonomy themselves as well. But the U.S. is very silent on this matter. And in fact, about the only thing they have done with the Iraqis moving into the area, causing many of the Kurds to flee this region for fear of their own lives, as we see in this article here on Defense News 4 days ago. Pentagon says Iraqi train and equip mission could end if attacks on Kurds continue. That's about the most the U.S. has gotten involved with this. In fact, when it first began, the U.S. was very silent about what was going on, and the Iraqi military has moved in, and it has caused, according to some words, that has caused a mass exodus of the Kurds leaving this region, fearful of reprisals of the Iraqi government. Well, that has really made me stop and step back and wonder, is this something that the U.S. is actually planning to happen? Is it something to help drive the Kurdish population from northern Iraq by staying out of what the Iraqi military is doing, and to cause those Kurds to either come closer to the border with Syria or in fact cross the border inside of Syria in order to create that state inside of Syria, or even cut out part of the northwestern part of Iraq? I think that's kind of an interesting take on this, because it doesn't make sense. If the U.S. is going to support the Kurds over here in the fight for the east of the Euphrates River against the Syrian government's wishes there, and no doubt to set up a Kurdistan or a Kurdish state inside of the Syrian government, inside of the Syria, which is kind of ironic because the predominant place for the Kurds is up in the very top eastern, far eastern, northeastern part of the country of Syria, which kind of goes along with the fact that there's a huge Kurdish population up in the east part of Turkey and as well as in northern Iraq there. So really this entire region is predominantly a Kurdish population. But it doesn't come all the way over here to the Euphrates, where Al Raqqa or Deir ez-Zor is, etc. These are all areas that are not Kurdish. But clearly, seeing as ISIS is failing in its own mission, the U.S. military advisors seem to think that it's a better idea to use the Kurdish fighters to completely drive out the population here and kill off anybody and everybody and take that as possibly their state. Now, it would benefit the U.S. with no doubt, because that is the oil-rich area of Syria. It is east of the Euphrates River. So no doubt it's definitely going to benefit the U.S. if they have a partnership with the Kurds. And wouldn't benefit so much over here when they know that they really can't get a Kurdistan inside of Iraq. But if the U.S. doesn't intervene and doesn't really help out, only maybe give a little bit of words there to make it look like they're helping out, it would serve the purpose that they're wanting to do in eastern part of Syria. Drive the Kurds out of northern Iraq into Syria there, where, once again, they'll have more manpower to help fight the war. and also possibly even eventually fight completely against President Bashar al-Assad with a whole new group of soldiers and to take the entire country. Maybe that's the in-game result of this all. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. If our broadcast is a blessing to you, please consider supporting the work we do here at Israeli News Live. You can go to israelinewslive.org or .co.il, and you can donate online. God bless you, and thank you for watching. Shalom.